Okay, we're going to talk about, Mr. T's going to help us here on why it's important to make sure your horse knows how to lower his head when you ask him to. A lot of benefits to having a horse to lower their head. It's a calming effect. Horses with high heads tend to be on alert. They're nervous, they're looking around, they're uncomfortable. So horses communicate with the position of their head. It's not just the ears, it's the whole body. How high their head is, which way they're facing, whether they're showing their butt, their flank. There's all kind of things that go into a horse communication. So when a horse has a high head, it can be a sign of a little disrespect. It can be a sign of strength, dominance, fear, concern, nervousness. So it's all kind of things that make a horse raise his head. So when you get the ability to make your horse lower his head, it's almost like a instinctive calming. A horse, it's tough for them to be on alert and be looking around when their head's not high. So, and if you work on this on the ground, then you're going to be able to work on it when you're on a saddle. And again, most things you do on the ground will transfer to when you're in a saddle. And it all goes down to horsemanship, being with your horse, making sure your horse understands what you want, communicating with your horse, etc. So the wind's blowing out here today. I've got the horse tied up here, so the wind is making him nervous. The other horses are kind of acting a little spooky today. Anytime you get in high winds, horses are going to get a little bit more spooky. And that's just normal horse stuff. Out in the wild, when a wind blows, it makes bushes rustle. So you can't tell if there's a predator or not. You can't tell if there's a lion. When you hear something, it puts their sensory on high alert. So anytime you're working in the wind, be aware that your horse is going to be a little bit more nervous. He can't hear as well. He hears bushes moving. It takes away his ability to hear. Now he sees everything moving instead of everything kind of calm. And when something moves, he can alert on it and make sure it's friend or foe. So the wind out here is blowing, and that's okay. The horse still needs to know how to listen. So we're going to get back to the head here. The few things that I like a horse to lower his head is I don't like reaching. When I see somebody coming up to a horse, and I'm going to make Tanner raise his head here, and I'm reaching all up here, and I'm trying to untie his knot, and his head's all high, and I see people reaching and pulling and fighting and doing. I'm like, you know what? If you taught your horse to lower head, you wouldn't have to do that. So when I ask a horse to lower his head, he should lower his head. 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 And there goes his head. And you can tell that body line is more straight. See his head? See that body line from the butt? Oh, there goes his head. It goes up. So I want his head a little bit lower because I want a level bottom. Head. 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 Good boy. There. Now I got a little bit more. Oh, there goes the head. It went back up. So see, the wind's blowing. There's something flapping. A truck just drove by with a tarp and it scared the other horses. So Tanner's on alert. There he goes. I don't know if you can hear that. And there's a horse running out there in the background. So Tanner's like, uh-oh, what's going on? Look at that head. Straight up. Look at, now you don't see a straight line. You see boom and that high head. So again, I want Tanner to lower his head. Head. And again, it's hard for me to get close enough and keep him in distance. Head. Good boy. Head. Good boy. Now asking him to lower his head, again, levels out that high line and makes him pay attention. See that head going back up? See, he's not paying attention to me. So I'm going to tell him again. Head. Head. Good boy. Now his head's nice and low. And as I walk away, it gets a little bit higher because I'm not there telling him. But you can tell that lower line there. And this head here makes it, when I go up to untie him, I want to be level. I want to be reaching straight out. I don't want to be reaching up. I want to be reaching straight out, and I want this knot right here, nice and easy. So when I untie it, his head's level. So when I want his head to drop, reach head. There you go. Look at that. Nice, nice lower head. Now I'm looking down, and that's what I want. I get a more straight line. And this horse knows what head is, so when I'm on his back and I say head, if he gets excited, or if we're out somewhere and the wind blows, or a coyote runs by, and his head goes straight up, and he's like, holy cow, what's going on? And his head goes up, so instinctively all his reactions start going into his prey mode, and it's like, I got to get my head high so I can see, I got to be ready to flight, I got to look bigger. All these things are running through his instinctual thing. I can get him to lower his head, and then instinctively it's a little bit like, oh, my head's low, I must be safe. Uh-oh, the threat must be gone. So I'm counteracting that instinctive high head, flight, worriedness, and I'm showing him, one, I'm still with you. Two, I'm still in control. Head. Head. Good boy. And if you look at that pole behind me there, that's going to give you a clue on how high his head is. So his head's a little bit above that pole now, and I'm going to make his head go a little bit lower. Head. Head. Good boy. Now it's below the pole. See his ears? Now he's going to slowly start working it higher because I'm see, there it goes. Now he just chased a fly and it irritated him, so his head went up a little bit. But that's why you want to really work on getting this. And to get your horse to do this, it's really pretty simple. You basically go up and you pet him, and then you're going to put a little bit of pressure on here, and I'm going to say head, and I'm going to pull down. As soon as he gives, I'm going to let go. What people want to do is they want to hang on that rope and pull, 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 and they don't want to release. I want to teach this horse, if you move your head 1/4 inch toward my hand when I give pressure, and if your horse knows how to give the pressure, he's going to do it pretty easy. So I'm going to reach over here, and I'm going to touch his rope and go, head, head, good boy. And he lowers that head, and I get that nice straight body line. And now Buddy back here is kind of sleeping, but you can tell his body line's a little straight. He's got that back leg cock, so he's kind of sleeping because he gets tied up a lot. So when he gets tied up, he just kind of goes into sleep and relax mode, which is good. That's what I want him to do. I don't want him pawing and acting all crazy, which he does sometimes if he's excited or whatever. But I've been tying him up the last few days, so he's kind of used to it. Same way with him. He's kind of relaxed and not giving me a problem, but I still, if I want this horse to lower his head, I'll try to switch hands here so I can keep this away. Head. Watch that tape. Watch this red line up here on where his ears and head's at, and you'll see it lower. Head. Head. Good boy. And now he just dropped his head a little bit more. And now his ears are below that red line. And now I have a straight line across his back here. And this is telling me he's more relaxed. This is telling me he's listening to me. This is telling me that he's paying attention to me and he's being responsive. So there's all kind of things that are going on. And people go, wow, so big deal. Your horse will lower his head when you say head. It's not about the head. Everything you do with the horse is about the big picture. That's what horsemanship is all about. Everything counteracts and compounds. So having a horse lower his head is a small, significant, little bitty thing. But it does so much more. It's a way to communicate with your horse. It's a way to make sure your horse is listening to you. It's a way to show dominance. You move a horse left, right, up, and down. By making him lower his head, I'm showing dominance. By him lowering his head, he's showing submissiveness. So having a horse lower his head when I tell him really tells me that he's connected, he's paying attention. Now, I guarantee you, if a truck or a motorcycle came by here with loud pipes and I tried to say head, neither of these horses would lower their head. They're like, you're crazy. There's a motorcycle with a loud noise that's moving like it's going to eat me. I am not lowering my head. And it would take practice and work. But that would tell me when a horse, it tells me his anxiety level. It tells me where his mind is at. If you control the mind, you control the feet. So getting a horse to lower his head just really is a calming effect. It makes them, it's part of the whole body. I always tell people, read your horse. Your horse is always talking to you. But the problem is most people don't want to listen. His tail is relaxed. His back feet are kind of cocked. His eyes are kind of a little bit droopy here, and he's kind of nodding off. He's shaking the flies a little bit, so the flies are annoying him, but he's trying to sleep a little bit. But all that, again, if I say head, now I'm gonna change it up here a little bit, and I'm going to say head by touching him on top instead of on the bottom, because I don't want him to think I have to always pull on a rope. So I'm going to touch him on top, say head, and he moves away from my hand. Head, head, and he moves away from my hand. Head, head, and he moves down. So he knows the word head because every time I've touched that rope and he's lowered his head, he knows what it means. And again, don't make this seem like, it's not a big deal or I don't need to do that. This is really important. When your horse will lower it, this is going to make it easier when I catch him, when I'm tying his halter, when I'm untying his halter, when I'm putting on his, if I was putting on a bridle, when I'm putting on his bozelle. All that matters because it tells me the horse is paying attention to me. And he's listening to me, and he's responding, and he's telling me that we're communicating, that I'm giving a signal, and he's listening and responding and cooperating. And all that helps tell me where his head's at, where our relationship is that day. Do I need to be aware of some other things? If he's in pain, he may not lower his head. If he saw a coyote and he's laying in the bushes and I don't see him, he may not lower his head. But all those things are going to tell me, why isn't he doing this? And I know it's odd because he always does it, because I always do it. And we have a routine, and it makes good habits. And because of that, I know when something's odd. I know when something's wrong. I can feel it. And when you feel your horse and you read him and you understand him, that's when your horsemanship grows. That's when you become a better horseman. That's when your horse feels more comfortable. That's when they feel safer, because they know that you know. I always tell people, a horse knows if you know. And when a horse, you know, I can give Tanner to a bunch of people. He won't lunge. He won't do anything. He'll pull away. He'll do all kind of crazy things. They're like, man, that horse is crazy. And I'll say, well, why does he do it with me? Well, he's used to you. Or he's a man's horse. Or It doesn't matter. A horse knows if you know. So work on your horsemanship, and your horsemanship, if you take care of your horsemanship will take care of you. So that's how to get your horse to lower his head and the importance of having him do that. Hope that helps.